long, long ago, in your grandfather's grandfather's time, there was a man named Michael O'Malley. And Michael O'Malley lived in a little village called Ballaghadereen in the west of Ireland in County Mayo. And Michael O'Malley was a peddler. And that meant that he would walk the streets and the roads and the lanes and the highways and the byways of Western Ireland, County Mayo and County Roscommon, with a great big heavy pack on his back. And in his pack he had, pots and pans and needles and scissors and thread and rolls of lace and shoes and a few books and whatever else he could find and sell and things that every honest Irish household needed. Well, as you can imagine, being a peddler was not the most lucrative of professions, and Michael O'Malley was a very poor man. And the cottage that he lived in Ballaghadereen, was mostly open to the weather. There were holes in the roof where the rain came leaking through, and the glass was broken out of the windows. And in the spring, the birds would fly in and out, and they would make their nests in the rafters up over his head. But in the garden out behind this cottage, there was a beautiful old russet apple tree, a wonderful tree, and every year it would produce an abundance of fruit, and in the autumn it would drop those russet apples to the ground, and they were the sweetest and most delicious apples in all of Ballaghadereen. Well, one night Michael O'Malley was fast asleep in his little tiny cottage when he had a dream. And in the dream, he saw a figure, and he thought that maybe it was St. Patrick himself, but he heard the voice of this figure, clear as moonlight, and the voice said to him, "Michael O'Malley, take the road to Dublin and go to the bridge over the River Liffey, and there you will hear something that will change your life." He woke and he sat up with a start, but there was nobody else in the room there, and it was absolutely still and quiet. The only sound was the gentle snoring of his little dog at the foot of his bed. And he said to himself, well, it was only a dream. And he lay back down, and he rolled over, and he went back to sleep. But the next night, there was the same dream. There was that man and that voice, as clear as moonlight, "Michael O'Malley, take the road to Dublin and go to the bridge over the River Liffey, and there you will hear something that will change your life." Every night he would have this dream. He would see that shadowy figure, and he would hear that voice as clear as moonlight, until Michael O'Malley started thinking to himself, well, dreams are strange things, and sometimes they're not really worth paying attention to, but sometimes they are, and I wonder if this is one of those dreams that I should pay attention to. And the dream kept coming to him again and again and again. And finally he decided that this was a dream that he should listen to. And he emptied out his backpack, his rucksack, and he rolled up his blanket as a bedroll. And he threw some cheese and some bread and a few of those beautiful russet apples in. And he put it on his shoulder and he whistled to his little dog. And he started to walk across Ireland. And he tramped and he trudged and he walked for 5 days down the streets and the roads and the lanes and the highways and the byways, and finally he came to Dublin town, and there was the bridge over the River Liffey stretched out in front of him. Now in those days, the bridge was very, very wide. It was a very wide thoroughfare, and there were shops and houses built right on the bridge on both sides. And Michael O'Malley had never seen such a sight. He came up onto the bridge, and there were people coming and going, and all these shops and houses, and there were horses pulling carts and carriages, and men pushing wheelbarrows, and such a hustle and bustle. There were more people on that one bridge over the River Liffey than in all of Ballaghadereen back at home. And Michael O'Malley, now that he was there, he was like, What am I supposed to do? I mean, the dream said that I would hear something that would change my life, but how am I supposed to hear that? So he walked back and forth over the bridge a few times, and then finally he just came to the center of the bridge, and he stood in front of one of the shops, and he just stood there all day, and he waited, and he waited, and he waited, and he waited, but nothing happened. He didn't hear anything important or interesting or that seemed like it would change his life. Night fell, and he went down underneath the bridge, and he slept on the bank of the river. And when he woke in the morning, he was cold and he was hungry. And he came back up onto the bridge, and he wandered from one end to the other, but still he didn't know where he was supposed to hear this marvelous thing that would change his life. And he sat down in front of one of the shops. It was a cobbler's shop. And he started thinking to himself, well, dreams are strange, and sometimes they're worth listening to, and sometimes they're not. And I suppose that this was not a dream that I should have listened to. I suppose I was foolish to come halfway across Ireland. And he got to his feet, and he had just about made up his mind that he was going to begin the long, long, long journey back to Ballaghadereen, when the door of the cobbler shop opened, and who should come out but the cobbler himself. And the cobbler looked at him right in the eye, and he said, well, stranger, who are you, and what are you doing here? I watched you all day yesterday. You just stood there on the bridge like a lost soul and didn't speak to anybody. And here you are again this morning, just shivering. And what's your story? Who are you? Why have you come here? What's up with you? So Michael O'Malley told him, well, I had a dream. And in this dream, I heard a voice as clear as moonlight. And the voice said to me, go to Dublin. And go to the bridge over the River Liffey, and there you'll hear something that will change your life. And the cobbler started to laugh his head off. He just threw his head back, and he roared, and he said, ha, dreams. Let me tell you something, stranger. Dreams are crazy. Dreams are nonsense. You do not want to put any stock in dreams. You do not want to give any credence to dreams. Why? Dreams are ridiculous. In fact, last night I had a dream, the craziest dream I ever had. I was in some little tiny village somewhere. What was it called? Ballaghadereen or something like that. You ever hear of such a place? Crazy name. And in my dream, there was a little cottage that was half open to the weather, and the birds were flying in and out of the broken windows. And behind this cottage, there was an old russet apple tree, and I was digging among the roots of that tree with a spade. And there was a big clay pot buried in the roots of the apple tree, and I struck it with my shovel, and it cracked open, and gold coins started pouring out into the soil. Do you ever hear of such a crazy dream? But do you think that I'm going to trudge halfway across Ireland looking for some place called Ballaghadereen and digging in somebody's garden under the roots of their apple tree looking for dream gold? Well, never in your life. And he threw his head back and he roared with laughter until his belly shook and the tears rolled down his cheeks. And while he was laughing, Michael O'Malley turned on his heel and he whistled to his dog and they started walking as fast as they could. And they walked and they walked and they walked for 5 days across the streets and the roads and the lanes and the highways and the byways until they came back to his little cottage in Ballaghadereen. And when he got there, he didn't stop to rest. He picked up a spade and he went out into the garden and he started digging among the roots of that old russet apple tree. And sure enough, it wasn't long before the edge of his spade struck a clay pot that was buried in the roots there, and the pot broke open, and golden coins by the dozen, by the hundred, maybe by the thousand, came pouring out into the soil. Well, that was the end of Michael O'Malley's peddler days. No more tramping and trudging the roads and the lanes and the highways and the byways for him. There was money enough to fix the holes in his roof where the rain was leaking in. There was money enough to put glass in his windows and close up the cottage. There was money enough for him to eat whenever he was hungry and to drink whenever he was thirsty. And all the money that was more than enough, and there was plenty of that, he gave to the poor and the hungry and the homeless. And so Michael O'Malley lived in great contentment, and he lived a long and happy life. And in his older years, he would often wax poetic and philosophical. And sometimes when he had had a pint or two, or maybe a dram of good Irish whiskey, he would light his pipe, and he would smoke, and he would think. And he would often say, dreams are strange things, and sometimes they're not worth paying attention to, but sometimes they are.
Thanks.